I've had a lot of tacos in Mexico City in the 2.5 weeks that I've been here so far. And while they are all great, and I do mean great, there's one that I love more than the others, and that is poblano con queso. Basically, grilled poblano peppers chopped up and melted with cheese. That's it. It's one of the most simple tacos you could make, but I absolutely love it. There was only one thing left for me to do, and that was recreate it to share with all of you. Today, I'm gonna try to recreate that taco for you in the home kitchen. So right now, I'm standing outside of Mercado. I don't even know how to pronounce it. It's like Cuamahatec or something. You're gonna need to look that up. But before I go in and get the ingredients for this, I'm actually gonna take you back to yesterday when I went and had poblanos con queso again and actually learned a couple important things. All right, everyone, so we're headed to Tacos Los Parados, which surprisingly enough was recommended by Rick Bayless. So we have a family friend who has worked with Rick before, and when they went down to Mexico City, Rick gave them a recommendations list. Our family friend passed that recommendations list on to me. So that is how I found out about the Tacos Los Parados. And then actually in that recommendation list, Rick said not to miss the poblano tacos. So that's where we're gonna go. I'll meet you guys when we're there. I got about a 15 minute walk. And then and we gotta go secure these tacos. All right, so we've got Tacos Los Parados behind us. Sorry if it's really loud, it's by a main road. Doesn't look too busy, I think they just opened, so hopefully I can film, hopefully they don't mind me filming a little bit. But if not, I'll meet you guys back out here and I'll walk you through those ingredients. So I'm definitely glad I went back because I actually learned a couple of new things while I was there. Also, shout out to everyone in there for letting me film. I just asked the guy who was making my tacos if he minded if I filmed him. He's like, yeah, it's fine. So I made sure to leave him a good tip because I feel like that's the thing to do. But cool things that I learned was, one, they actually dropped the whole poblano, and it's already stuffed with cheese, into the charcoal. Like they lift up the grill grate, which I didn't even realize that they do. And then the second thing that I learned was, I thought it was Oaxaca cheese that they use because it melts really good, but it's like a Manchego cheese. So I'll just make sure to do that research tomorrow when I go to the market, make sure I pick up the right things. But super glad that I came back to learn those couple of things, and it's gonna make our experience in the home version that much better. All right, so we're gonna fast forward back to present day and get our ingredients. Peace. All right, so hopefully that got you guys excited for the poblanos con queso. I know it got me excited just re-editing that bit. So to round out this taco, I'm gonna make a salsa morita, which is just like a red salsa with the morita chili, one of my favorite chilies. And then of course, knowing me, I'm gonna make a little pickled onion. It's gonna be super delicious. So I'm gonna pop into this market. Just get some little clips here and there, but I'm not gonna like talk or film or anything. And then I will meet you guys back in the kitchen once I have all those ingredients. I've got the goodies.
Bless my love. All right, I've got the ingredients, and we're gonna quickly run through our different components. So first up is going to be the salsa, because that's where you start with, you know, if you're going to a taqueria, like, they already have the salsas, they already got little accoutrements ready, so that's how the same order we're gonna cook today. So first up is gonna be a salsa roja, really, really simple. We've got tomatoes, we've got a little bit of onion, we've got a garlic clove, and then this is what's gonna tie everything together and give us a little bit of spice and uniqueness, and that is a dried chili. This is a chipotle meco. So basically, I actually have a regular chipotle right here. So these are both jalapenos, but this one's bigger and riper, and it's smoked for a lot longer. And while they are both smoked, they definitely have different flavor profiles. And I think originally I said I was gonna use chili morita, but the stand that I stopped up in the market didn't have one. So when I saw these, I was like, let's do this, because I've been meaning to try to make a salsa with these and I can't wait. Seriously, the smells on this, absolutely unbelievable. Next up is just gonna be a little fresh topping, some pickled onions and habaneros. So I'm just gonna slice these really thin, and then we're gonna also add in a little bit of cilantro, and then to actually like use the pickling liquid, I didn't bother getting vinegar. I was just like, let's just use limes, it's super easy. If you guys saw my what you can cook for $10 video, basically I'm gonna follow that same exact process, except we'll be using some habaneros for a little bit of spice, you know? The main event. We've got these beautiful, look at these things are massive, beautiful habaneros. And then I've got this manchego cheese. So manchego cheese in Mexico is way different than the manchego cheese that is made in Spain, and probably how manchego cheese is sold in the States. Actually, I didn't even realize this, but manchego cheese in Mexico is made with, I think, goats and cow's milk, and it's a melting cheese, whereas the version in Spain is really not used for melting. So actually, let's give this a little taste. And yeah, oh, that smells so good. And yeah, it's definitely not like manchego cheese in the States. It's got kind of that like Monterey Jack almost kind of texture and flavor too. But really good cheese is gonna go perfect in melting inside these. And then last but not least, I got fresh tortillas from the market. Like, seriously, if you ever get the chance to go to a market, just pick up a kilo of fresh tortillas. Like, I've eaten probably like 3 or 4 of these just while they've been sitting around. They're so, so good. They have the fresh masa, they run them through, and they literally come out steaming hot, ready for you. And like I said, they're super, super cheap. These are like 15 pesos, which is like a little bit less than a dollar. And I'm just telling you, easily the best tortillas I've ever had. And how could I forget one last ingredient? You guys know me, salt, always super, super important in whatever you're cooking. It's gonna enhance and accentuate all our flavors, so they're gonna be used throughout the salsas, the poblano tacos, and everything. But first up, we're gonna start with that salsa. Basically, we just need to roast everything up and throw it in a blender. It's really as simple as that. So to prep our ingredients, basically all I did was just chop the top off of these, and we're just gonna lay everything onto a pan. No oil or anything, but it's gotta be hot, about medium high. And basically, we're just looking to get some nice charred bits. You're gonna wanna leave this stuff on there for a good while. Probably the first thing that's gonna come off is the chili, but everything else, you kinda wanna just let it sit, develop that good browning on the outside, because that is what is going to give the salsa that great flavor. All right, we have started the flavor building. Everything is nice and roasted, and seriously, you do really want your like tomatoes and your onions to be really, really roasted. And then for the chilies, you just wanna make sure that they're like nice and toasty. They shouldn't smell burnt, like seriously. Oh my God. Like this chili, I don't know why I like the smell of it so much, but I cannot express, like, there's something about it that just like Ooh, gets me excited. And then basically all that I need to do is actually just toss this chili to soften it up a bit. I'm just gonna toss it in this water, let it sit for about 15 minutes, and then it's as simple as throwing everything in the blender and adding salt. Literally, that's it. And you're gonna have this awesome salsa that takes like no time, but it's all about building up those flavors. So let me soak this, and then I'll blend this, and then we'll do a little taste test. All right, now it is time for the most important part of making salsa, and really almost all foods, and that is adding salt. So if I taste this right now, so you taste all those components in there, but they're really lacking. It's pretty bland. So that is when you gotta come in with the salt. And basically you just wanna add a little bit, you can do it gradually at a time, and just stir it in and taste how the salsa changes. And I'm telling you, this is gonna be one of the biggest things from making a good salsa to a great salsa. Also, I'm using like a bunch of mugs and things because there's not like small bowls, there's only like these big bowls in this Airbnb, so. Yeah, literally makes the hugest difference, I'm telling you. Like, it brings out everything and just really like shocks your taste buds, brings up that spiciness a little bit. And I'm telling you, this salsa, absolutely killer. Like, you could bottle this up, sell it, it'd be a hit, I guarantee it. And it's super simple. Like, what is it? Tomatoes, onions, garlic, a chipotle meco, and then salt, and you know, you're good to go. Like, it's literally as simple as that. And that's really what I feel like a lot of Mexican food is about. It's not overly complicated. It's not a ton of ingredients. Like, obviously there are some dishes that are a ton of ingredients, like mole. A big part of it is really just simple ingredients and just really building up those flavors. And that's exactly what this salsa is. So now we have the salsa done and out of the way, we're gonna move on to our kind of pickled accoutrement, not really pickled, but just basically everything sitting in lime juice. Just gonna chop it up, throw the limes in, salt it, and then we will be good to go and we can get back on the path to our poblano con queso tacos. So we've got our next topping done and ready to go. And like I said, super simple again. Just onions, cilantro, habaneros, you could use jalapenos, you could not use any. And then I just squeezed in about one full lime. And then as always, just finish it with a little bit of salt. And then this will just get better and better as it sits. Like, it's just like a simple freshness that is gonna contrast well with tacos, right? So most tacos in Mexico, you know, when you get them, they just hand them out and it's just like, it's just literally a tortilla and there's meat on it. They don't actually top them up. So you have the option to do that with all the different toppings that they offer and the different salsas. So this one works for me. A little bit of spicy in there with the habaneros, but try to find something that's a little crunchy, a little acidic, a little, maybe a little spicy, or maybe some bite from some onion. Can't beat it. But enough of that. This is done and out of the way. All right, so now it is time for our main event, and I cannot wait to absolutely just make and devour these. So basically what they do at Tacos Los Parados is they cut the tops off of the poblano, then they shove in a big chunk of manchego cheese, and yeah, obviously I'm not gonna skimp on the manchego cheese. I'll probably use like maybe that much, like all the way down for one of these, and I'm not gonna make both of them right now, I'll just do one. But then after they put the cheese inside, they throw it underneath the grill where all that charcoal is to get it all blistered up on the outside. Then they bring it out, and then that's when they like chop it up and the cheese melts even more and gets all really good. So really what they're doing is building the flavor by charring the outside. And obviously since, you know, I'm in an apartment right now, probably a lot of you are too. You know, you may not have access to a charcoal grill. So what we're gonna do instead is actually broil these with the cheese inside and blister them all on the outside and just rotate them so it's all out on the outside. And that is really what's gonna build up that flavor. But first steps first is just getting these prepared with our cheese and then throwing them in the broiler, and then I'll meet you guys back when that is done. So remember how I said we were gonna broil these? Well, I don't actually know if this oven has a broiler. I don't understand how it works. So I can't turn to that setting, and then obviously I can use this heat, but then when I use the igniter, like, nothing happens. And then also, I don't know why this rack is like forcefully connected into here. Like, you can't put anything on the top rack. So I think instead of using the broiler, what I'm gonna do is actually just toss the poblano right on top of this gas grill, no pan, to get all those blistered marks, and it should blister up very well. But obviously I just gotta be a little careful so the cheese doesn't like melt everywhere. So that's what I'm gonna do, but if you were at home, I'd probably suggest just go ahead and using the broiler. It's probably gonna be easiest, but you gotta work with what you gotta do sometimes. Makes me so happy. So surprisingly enough, that actually worked out really good on the burner. I did lose the cheese. I'm sure you guys saw it included in the video, but it came back in nicely. So basically I've got this all blistered up on the outside, just smells so good. And then that cheese has started to melt in there. And then basically what they do at Tacos Los Prados is they just chop everything up and they kind of finely dice it into like little pieces. And then they just saute it like down on their little griddle. So I'm just gonna do that in the pan. And then that's all there is to it. You just throw it on some fresh tortillas. And yeah, we're gonna have ourselves a delectable meal. So let me chop this up, fry it up, and then I'll meet you guys back here when the tacos are ready to eat. Ladies and gents, we did it. This is, I mean, it obviously we don't have that charcoal flavor, but I'm telling you, like, this is the absolute texture I wanted. That manchego melts so good with those poblanos. And we're gonna go in and give it just a taste test plain first, and then we'll add our salsa and our little pickled onions. I'm telling you, I could eat this taco every single day. The poblanos are so nice, like, because there's like a little bit spice on their own to poblanos. Not much. I think poblanos are like 2,000 or 3,000 Scoville units. So it's kind of like half of a jalapeno or something. But I'm telling you, oh my gosh. But when you pair it with salsa and our little pickled onions for a little bit of acidity and crunch, like, now time to try that loaded bite. I mean, I'm sure you guys can tell, like, I'm absolutely amped about this taco. There are a lot of great other tacos that I've had down here, but there's something about like the simplicity of Poblano's con queso and just like the freshness of it mixed with that Manchego cheese, and oh my gosh. One thing, let me try it with the Nopales that I made. So this is a video that's coming out in a couple days, but basically it's this Nopales topping that I found since I've been in Mexico. Another really, really good topping. We're gonna try this with it too. And at first I thought it was pickled, but I actually found out it's not. And you guys are gonna have to see in the video. It's a pretty interesting story actually, but I'm telling you, this topping is a really, really good one to make too. And luckily for me, I have more Manchego and another huge Poblano. So I'm definitely gonna be making these again this week. And especially once you have like the salsas and the pickled onions made, like it's really as simple as just crisping and broiling or using the gas burner for your poblano, stuffing the cheese inside, and then just sauteing up. Like you could have this ready in like 5 minutes. Like that is a great, great all around meal. Super quick bite, but absolutely delicious. That's gonna wrap it up for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you are enjoying the content, definitely drop me a like and subscribe. And if you guys wanna see like what I'm up to on a more like day-to-day basis, go ahead and follow my Instagram. Basically, since I've been down here, I've just been posting every single time I eat something, trying to learn more about the cuisine. So there's a lot of little good nuggets of information if you guys are interested about kind of Mexican cuisine and food and you know, what kind of things they eat down here. But I'm absolutely loving my time so far. But I still have a couple more weeks to go and I've got some good videos planned. We're gonna do some authentic enchiladas, I think later next week maybe. But anyway, hopefully you guys are enjoying and I will catch you in the next video. Peace.